Hello everyone, I am Dr. Trupti. Welcome to my channel Enjoy Biochemistry. Today you are going to learn a very important topic, von Gogh disease, with the help of a case study. This topic is very important for theory examination. It can come as short answer question. It can be asked in Viva also, and various MCQs can be asked on this topic, von Gogh disease as well as glycogen storage diseases. Let's first understand what are glycogen storage diseases. These are a group of genetic diseases that result from a defect in an enzyme required for glycogen synthesis or degradation, which means that if there is defect in glycogen synthesis or degradation, that is glycogenolysis, it can result in glycogen storage disease. They result either in the formation of glycogen that has abnormal structure or excessive accumulation of normal glycogen in specific tissues where that glycogen degradation is impaired. For example, if enzyme defective in liver, then there is accumulation of glycogen in the liver, or if the defect is in the muscle, then accumulation of glycogen will occur in the muscle. And it can also affect various other tissues like liver, muscle, kidney, intestine and myocardium. The severity of glycogen storage disease, it ranges from fatal in infancy to mild disorders that are not life-threatening. So let's first understand the glycogenolysis in short so that we can understand the defects of glycogen storage diseases. This is a structure of glycogen which is degraded by the action of enzyme glycogen phosphorylase to form limit dextrin. Limit dextrin is further degraded by debranching enzyme, which is a bifunctional enzyme, and it results in the formation of unbranched glycogen. This unbranched glycogen is further acted upon by glycogen phosphorylase and debranching enzyme, ultimately to form glucose-1-phosphate as well as free glucose. Now, what is the fate of this glucose-1-phosphate? This glucose-1-phosphate is converted to glucose-6-phosphate by the action of enzyme phosphoglucomutase. Now the fate of this glucose-6-phosphate in muscle is different and the fate in liver is different. So let's consider this as a liver tissue. And what is the fate of this glucose-6-phosphate in liver? Let's see. So this is schematic representation of a cell. Means liver cell, it has endoplasmic reticulum in it, and this endoplasmic reticulum has a very important enzyme, that is glucose-6-phosphatase, and that's why this glucose-6-phosphate has to enter this endoplasmic reticulum. So this glucose-6-phosphate enters endoplasmic reticulum by transporter, that is glucose-6-phosphate translocase. It comes in the endoplasmic reticulum and converted or broken down to free glucose by action of enzyme glucose-6-phosphatase. Later, it comes out of the endoplasmic reticulum and then it comes in the circulation. This glycogen can also be converted to glucose in the lysosomes. About 1-3% of glycogen is converted to glucose by the action of enzyme acid maltase in the lysosome to form this glucose. Now, let's see various glycogen storage diseases. If there is defect in glucose-6-phosphatase enzyme in liver, it results in type 1A glycogen storage disease. It is called as von Gogh's disease. In this von Gogh's disease, there is accumulation of normal glycogen. And this is autosomal recessive disease which affects liver, kidney and intestine. And the various clinical features are hypoglycemia, ketosis, acidosis with increased lactic acid, increased uric acid and hepatomegaly. Type 1B glycogen storage disease is due to glucose-6-phosphate translocase deficiency. In addition to the clinical features of von Gogh disease, it also has neutropenia, and that's why patient suffers from various severe infections. Type 2 glycogen storage disease is called as Pompe's disease, and it is due to defect in enzyme lysosomal acid maltase, and there is accumulation of glycogen in the lysosomes. So in this Pompe's disease, it is also autosomal recessive disease, and the glycogen which is accumulated is of normal structure. It affects liver, heart, smooth and striated muscle, and the patient can have cardiomegaly, muscle hypotonia, but there is no hypoglycemia. Then comes type 3 glycogen storage disease. It is called as Forbes disease or Cori's disease. It is also called as limit dextrinosis, and it is due to defect in debranching enzyme. So this defect in debranching enzyme leads to accumulation of abnormal glycogen in liver, heart and muscle. This is also autosomal recessive condition. Patient presents with moderate hypoglycemia, acidosis, progressive myopathy and hepatomegaly as well. Type 4 glycogen storage disease is associated with the glycogenesis, and it is due to defect in branching enzyme, and there is accumulation of abnormal structure of glycogen which affects liver, heart, muscle, etc. Then comes type 5 glycogen storage disease, which is due to defect in enzyme glycogen phosphorylase which is present in muscle, and it is called as MacArdle syndrome. So you can remember as M, MacArdle and muscle. So MacArdle syndrome is due to defect in muscle glycogen phosphorylase, and the accumulated glycogen structure is normal. It is also autosomal recessive condition which affects skeletal muscle mostly, and it leads to muscle cramps on exercise, pain in muscle, weakness and stiffness of muscle. Then comes type 6 glycogen storage disease. It is due to hepatic glycogen phosphorylase defect, and the name of disease is Hirsch disease. So H for hepatic. You can remember like this. Hirsch disease is due to defect in hepatic glycogen phosphorylase. It is also due to accumulation of normal glycogen, and it affects liver, leukocytes. Patient have hypoglycemia, mild to moderate acidosis and hepatomegaly. Now let's enumerate various glycogen storage diseases and their enzyme defect. Type 1A glycogen storage is von Goeg's disease. It is due to glucose 6 phosphatase deficiency. Type 2 is Pomp's disease. It is due to defect in acid maltase. Type 3 is Cori's disease or Forbes disease. It is also called as limit dextrinosis. It is due to defect in debranching enzyme. Type 4 is due to defect in branching enzyme of glycogenesis. It is called as Anderson's disease. Type 5 is MacArdle syndrome. It is due to defect in muscle glycogen phosphorylase. Type 6 is called as Hirsch disease. It is due to hepatic or liver glycogen phosphorylase defect. Type 7 is Tourette's disease. It is due to defect in muscle and RBC phosphofructokinase. Type 8 glycogen storage disease is due to liver phosphorylase kinase deficiency. Type 9 GSD, that is glycogen storage disease, is due to defect in liver and muscle phosphorylase kinase defect. And type 10 GSD is due to defect in protein kinase A. A 1-year-old female child presented to the hospital with progressive abdominal distension, vomiting and lethargy for 2 months. She had no history of seizures or recurrent infections. She had slightly delayed development, and there was a history of death of a cousin during infancy due to liver disease. On physical examination, the child showed rounded doll's face, fatty cheeks and a protuberant abdomen. She had massive and firm hepatomegaly. Kidneys were also palpable, but spleen was not palpable. Laboratory report showed low blood glucose level, that is hypoglycemia, high lactic acid level, hyperlipidemia, hyperuricemia, mild elevation in liver enzymes. ABC analysis showed high anion gap, metabolic acidosis, and Benedict test was negative. Liver biopsy showed hepatocytes contained greater than normal amounts of glycogen. So this is a case study of type 1A glycogen storage disease, that is von Goeg's disease. Common questions on von Goeg's disease are: mention the most likely diagnosis and justification for the same. Mention the cause of the condition. Mention the biochemical basis of hepatomegaly, fasting hypoglycemia, hyperlactacidemia, metabolic acidosis, hyperuricemia, hyperlipidemia, biochemical basis of delayed growth, that is development, biochemical basis of doll's face in the patient. Then which other investigation should be done in this patient and how the condition can be managed. So these are the common questions. The most likely condition is type 1A glycogen storage disease, that is Wernicke disease. The justification for the same is that the patient is presented with clinical features of progressive abdominal distension and it is maybe due to hepatomegaly, and there was history of slightly delayed development which is common in Wernicke disease. Death of cousin during infancy due to liver disease also shows that it can be a genetic disease. And rounded doll face, fatty cheeks and protuberant abdomen, these are the common clinical features of Wernicke disease. Hepatomegaly and renomegaly are also important features of Wernicke disease due to deposition of glycogen in liver as well as kidney. Laboratory reports also shows hypoglycemia, high lactic acid level, high lipid levels, high uric acid levels and high anion gap metabolic acidosis, which is suggestive of Wernicke disease. And liver biopsy also shows that hepatocyte contains greater than normal amount of glycogen which is of normal structure. So all these findings, they favor the diagnosis of type 1A glycogen storage disease, that is Wernicke disease. The second question is, mention the cause of condition. So the Wernicke disease is due to defect in glucose 6 phosphatase. So when glucose 6 phosphatase is deficient, then glucose 6 phosphate cannot be converted into glucose, and this conversion of glucose 6 phosphate to glucose is very important in both the processes, that is glycogenolysis and gluconeogenesis. So this enzyme plays very important role in both the processes, which are important in fasting and starvation. So if glucose 6 phosphatase is defect, then in fasting and starvation the patient cannot synthesize glucose from various non-carbohydrate sources as well, or there cannot be degradation of glycogen which is there in the liver, and that's why patient presents here with the fasting hypoglycemia. Now what is the biochemical basis of hepatomegaly, fasting hypoglycemia, hyperlactatemia, metabolic acidosis, hyperuricemia and hyperlipidemia? Let's find out. Glucose 6 phosphate is the product which is formed from glycogenolysis, that is due to breakdown of glycogen, as well as from gluconeogenesis, that is synthesis of glucose from non-carbohydrate precursors. This glucose 6 phosphate then converted into glucose by the action of enzyme glucose 6 phosphatase, which is present in liver. The other fate of glucose 6 phosphate can be, it is channeled to HMP shunt to form ribose 5 phosphate and NADPH. If this glucose 6 phosphatase, if it is deficient or it is defective, then this glucose 6 phosphate, which is a product of glycogenolysis as well as gluconeogenesis, it cannot be converted into glucose in liver and it cannot help to maintain blood glucose homeostasis, and that's why it results in decreased glucose concentration, and that's why fasting hypoglycemia. Why fasting? Because both these processes, glycogenolysis as well as gluconeogenesis, these are the processes of fasting and starvation. Because when in the post-absorptive stage, when blood glucose concentration decreases, then glycogen metabolism is activated, and this glycogenolysis will provide glucose up to 18 hours in post-absorptive phase, and later on then blood glucose homeostasis will be maintained by this gluconeogenesis. So both the processes are important to maintain blood glucose concentration in fasting and starvation, and that's why the patient presents with fasting hypoglycemia. So when glucose 6 phosphate cannot be converted into glucose, the fate of this glucose 6 phosphate is accumulation of this glucose 6 phosphate as glycogen, because it will be get converted into glycogen by the process of glycogenesis, and there will be increased concentration of glycogen, and this glycogen will get accumulated. This glycogen is of a normal structure, and this normal structure glycogen will get accumulated in the liver and it results in hepatomegaly. That is the biochemical basis of hepatomegaly in von Goeg's disease. Then what happens in the hypoglycemia? There is increased glucagon and epinephrine, and this results in increased lipolysis. Lipolysis means breakdown of triacylglycerol, which are stored in adipose tissue. So increased lipolysis will result in increased concentration of free fatty acid. So these free fatty acids then tend to get accumulated as triglyceride in the liver, and ultimately it results in the condition called as fatty liver. So fatty liver is also common condition in von Goeg's disease. Now this free fatty acid, if they undergo beta oxidation, there is formation of acetyl-CoA. Now whenever there is increased acetyl-CoA pull, it results in the concentration of synthesis of cholesterol. So this lipolysis will result in increased cholesterol synthesis. That's why in the patients of von Goeg disease, there is increased cholesterol as well as there is increased triglyceride. So there is increased hyperlipidemia. This is the biochemical basis of hyperlipidemia. Now this acetyl-CoA can also be converted into ketone bodies, and excessive ketone bodies leads to condition of ketosis, and that's why ketosis is common in von Goeg's disease. Now when hepatic glycogenolysis cannot occur, the glycogenolysis is favored in muscle and it results into excessive production of lactate, which cannot be cleared as this glucose 6 phosphatase enzyme is defective, means not present in the muscle. So then there is increased concentration of lactic acid in the muscle, and it results in lactic acidosis, which is high anion gap metabolic acidosis. Now as this glucose 6 phosphate concentration is increased, there is more conversion of this glucose 6 phosphate into ribose 5 phosphate through this HMP shunt. So there is increased production of this ribose 5 phosphate. That's why there is increased purine synthesis and degradation as well. And what is the end product of purine degradation? It is uric acid. And this lactic acid also compete with this uric acid for excretion, and that's why there is increased uric concentration in blood, which results in hyperuricemia. So this is the biochemical basis of all the clinical features and laboratory findings. In addition to this, increased cholesterol leads to doll's face in the baby, and as there is no glycogenolysis or gluconeogenesis cannot occur, there is increased muscle breakdown, and it also leads to delayed growth development. The next question is, which other investigation should be done in this patient? So in this patient, enzyme assay for diagnosis of defect in glucose 6 phosphatase or mutation analysis can be done. As this disease affects kidneys as well, kidney function test, patient is prone to infections, so CBC, urine analysis, and estimation of various liver enzymes can also be done. How the condition can be managed? Because no specific treatment is available, symptomatic therapy is very important in these patients, and dietary treatment is also important. The primary goal of treatment is to correct hypoglycemia and to maintain the normoglycemic state. And this normoglycemic state can be achieved with overnight nasogastric infusion of glucose, parenteral nutrition, and per oral administration of raw cornstarch. Glucose molecules are continuously released by hydrolysis of raw cornstarch in the digestive tract over 4 hours following its intake. Fructose and galactose should be avoided because they cannot be converted to glucose and they do increase lactate production, and it is dangerous for such patients. And the limited intake of lipids is advisable because patient already has pre-existing hyperlipidemia. Now let's summarize von Goeg disease, which is type 1a glycogen storage disease, which occurs due to defect in glucose 6 phosphatase. This disease is autosomal recessive, which affects liver and kidney. This condition results in fatty liver. There is hepatomegaly as well as renomegaly and progressive renal disease. Patient presents with growth retardation and delayed puberty. There is accumulation of glycogen in liver, but the structure of glycogen is normal. Muscle is not affected in this condition as glucose 6 phosphatase is not present in muscle. There is severe fasting hypoglycemia. Patient also has hyperlactacidemia, high anion gap lactic acidosis, that is metabolic acidosis, hyperlipidemia, hyperuricemia. Treatment is symptomatic, nocturnal gastric infusion of glucose or regular administration of uncooked corn starch. I hope this video will be helpful to you. Thank you for watching.